ready to go. 1400. Off now, they're racing. It was Great Charade that actually bounced out in front. Blow Me Out. Crystal Dang being sent across the face of the field by Watson. She's going to look for the lead. She's going to get there within the first 200 and now takes off and speeds clear. Crystal Dane settled a length in front. Astro Warrior followed it across very quickly to be second. Then Guard the Safe up prominent. Blow Me Out dropped behind those to be fourth. A length and a half to two behind them. Cobb and Co. being followed on the rails next of all by Call Again. Three quarters Rule E posted deep in the run down the riverside. Great Charade getting back into the field with Little Red Bikini. Then What About Wah, Secret Deploy and Fire Sailor well back, and so's Dazzling Dane, who'd whipped them all in. There's no shortage of pace. 600 left to travel. Off the riverside they come. Crystal Dane looking for more rain. Drew a length and a half. Astro Warrior, the same margin. Guard the Safe. Blow Me Out was the first to come off the bridle. Down on the inside, Call Again. Rule E back in the middle is Cobb and Co. Secret Deploy standing the lead of the best part of 8-9 lengths at the top of the straight. Crystal Dane balances up in front. Watson says go again at the 200. Two and a half in front. Blow Me Out keeps coming down the outside. Crystal Dane still clear from Blow Me Out. Secret Deploy running on, but this is all over. Crystal Dane is going to run them into the ground again. And a double for Watson. Goes home. Crystal Dane beats Blow Me Out. Secret Deploy run third. In behind them, Cobb and Co. Dazzling Dane's a good run from last. And then came Little Red Bikini, Great Charade, deeper out in company with Rule Lee. Guard the Safe, Call Again, What About Moi, Astro Warrior weakening. It only beat one to the line, and that is Fire Sail. Crystal Dane does it again. Holly Watson comes up with a race-to-race double. Led them comfortably. Burned across, no issue. Going to 1400. No issue with the extra couple of clicks and beautifully rated in front. Crystal Dane makes it win 9 from 61 and in a real patch of form, hasn't just won, has won by a big margin. Blow Me Out. Second, Lucy Warwick. Third, number 8, Secret Deploy. Fourth, number 3, Cobb & Co. 1983 and 122.75, and clearly has tested the clock as well. 122 and three quarters, 35.62 the sectional, 2 1/4 by three quarters, and a mare who's very much in form for Dion Luciani, owned by La Loma Farms, by patronise out of Black Dane. Crystal Dane home, and jumped 750 with the WOP, but dominated them right from the outset. Second is the Alfred Nobel mare, Blow Me Out, who there'd been some specking for at 21 into 15. Brett Pope, Lucy Warwick, and Secret Deploy, who did stand them a big head start. Back there in the field, the Dash for Cash, Undercover Lizzie, three-year-old, Clint Johnston Porter for Adam Durant. Officially fourth, number 3, Cobb & Co. And Dazzling Dane ran fifth, and a good run too by that mare. She was back last, a clear last on the home corner, but certainly was doing her very best late in the event. Race 4, the Lex Piper Stakes this afternoon. 1,600 metres at 4 after 3. 8 recalled is the scratching there, and Patrick Carberry rides number 6, Let's Deal, in the first of our two feature events. Let's go downstairs now. Ian Glading represents trainer Dion Luciani, and he's with Brittany after the victory once again of Crystal Dane.
A wonderful victory, and you just can't doubt this mare. Ian Glading joins me now, and Ian, this mare, when she's in form, I know we spoke last time, purchased as a brood mare, but she just keeps on winning.
Yeah, she's just going from strength to strength, getting better and better. Getting up in the weights, we didn't think to get across that easy today, but she just cruised across and got a couple of easy furlongs in the middle, and plan was always to get going before the turn, which Holly did, and the horse just keeps going.
At the top of the straight, when she had put a couple on them, did you think the race was run, knowing that Adam had a pretty smart grey back in the field you knew would be finishing off strongly?
Yeah, Adam's a very good horse. But once you've got that brake on him, she does keep going. Very difficult to run down. She just tries her heart out. She's just a lovely little horse to do anything with. I was I was talking to the strapper before the race, and I said, gee, it'd be nice if they're all like her. She's just does everything you wanted, a just professional racehorse.
Mm. Absolutely. The horses you would like to put a saddle on every single time you're at the races. Well done to you. We'll get out of this sun.
Beautiful. Thank you.
There is Ian Gladding, and over in the shade, Holly Watson's with Scott.
Well, Holly, Crystal Dane, you said it was a let's hope job. Let's hope so. But what did you make of her win today?
Yeah, she's always very honest and everything, but she tried her guts out and won really well.
Seems to have gone to a new level since she's been ridden for speed too. She seems really comfortable out there.
Oh, she definitely loves taking you up there, so I'm happy to be there. Don't think I'd be able to hold her behind anything, but no, she's really nice to ride.
Congratulations, well done on a double.
Thanks, Slip.
There is Holly Watson, early double, only three races. Holly's won two of them. And Crystal Dane, the mare that was purchased to go to stud, missed the breeding season because they're a bit late. They thought, oh, well, you can go around in a few more races. And gee, isn't she banking checks for those connections? Crystal Dane takes out race number three.
I'm alive. I know you heard it from those other boys, but this time in between, it's something that I feel it. I know you heard it from those other boys, but this time it's real, it's something that I feel it. It feels like paradise running through your bloody veins, you know it's love heading your way. If it feels like paradise running through your bloody veins.